Hey everyone, Nick here from Firefly Studios. Today we're here in sunny Rome to discuss our new Romans Age of Caesar City Builder MMO. Now while I'm not currently out sketching the Colosseum and all its grandeur, exploring the Pantheon and all the various ruins in the city, we are going to discuss a very important question in game dev. Why are so many games set in Rome? Maybe it's the fact that the Roman Empire left such an impact over the last 2,000 years that we as game developers feel the need to recreate and reinterpret the lives of Roman citizens, allowing you to live through new technology and new experiences. It's an era that holds countless tales of heroic sacrifice and tragic defeat, these funneling through to TV, video games, comic books, movies, and countless other mediums. Video games present the unique opportunity to not only retell a tale from the history books and the Roman annals of the empire, but also to let you as a player experience what it was like to be a Roman citizen or to be a heroic figure of the time, seeing the consequences of your actions in a virtual world.
Et tu, Brute.
Within this complex progression of lifestyle, civil operations, trade and ideology, we as classic city builder developers see this as a fascinating opportunity in terms of game dev and game design. Just take a look at the number of excellent games set in the Roman Empire. You've got the micromanagement and complexity of Caesar III, the military might and grandeur of Rome Total War, the cinematic narrative-driven focus of Rise, and the politics, strategy and backstabbing of Romans Age of Caesar. Each illustrates a different aspect of Roman civilization, from the humble pleb up to the Roman heroic figure. For us, we're most interested in the way that Roman architects and planners were able to blueprint, schedule the construction of, build and operate these grand Roman cities, which were, in reality, far ahead of their time. This massive leap forward, with new systems in the way that roads were constructed, the introduction of aqueducts, training for the military, and even things like underfloor heating were a huge leap forward in terms of technology for the time, which makes perfect sense to marry this with our love of strategy, mechanics, and complex city building gameplay. Or maybe it's the sheer craftsmanship of the time, from the great mosaics to the ironwork of the military. So much of the empire was visual and therefore a great fit for video games and technology. This jump forward in visual design is a huge inspiration for video game developers who want to draw, animate, and program their way through the Roman Empire. And of course, it also helps to be business savvy. The market always wants new interpretations of Rome, and you rarely get the chance to play through the lives of Roman citizens, barbarians, and heroic figures from history. The Roman Empire seems to be constantly in the public psyche for reasons we've discussed. The military, politics, culture and theology of the time is rife for constant re-exploration and reinterpretation. With Romans Age of Caesar, we're hoping to cover as many aspects of Roman life and culture as possible. Build a district in a great city, forge relations with fellow governors and trade with them, recruit a legion to expand out into the Roman Empire, and eventually take on the Senate itself.